turned around here. Pulled one of these like this. You know, all the ones I've done have been, you know, fifth wheel hitch ones. This one's an old pedal hitch. Oh, back up way more. Still could have backed up more. That's right, we'll get this folded down, get a better look. That. I already had the hitch on here because I've been using this truck as a yard goat, moving trailers around our yard, into the shop and whatever. Well, I hope I reach it. It's hard for me to judge my distance of this truck, and I don't know why. Come on, just barely got her. We got her. Just barely. Axles both look bent. This thing in high speed? No, high speed don't work. Okay. Low speed it is. I like low speed. That's probably enough. Climb up here, just make sure there's no water in it. I'm sure there's not, but I always like to be sure. Hell, yeah, it's empty. Blocks.
Oh,
drug it getting it out. Drug it pretty good, huh? You chain the crossbar so that it doesn't turn and it turns on the hitch. You guys remember from the gooseneck video. Like I say, this stuff's usually put away, but I've been using this truck as a yard goat, so everything's already out. Bungee out already. Yep. Turns should be okay. like that, you know? Yeah. So one issue I've got with this truck is got this hook right here, and sometimes if you have it, the safety chain just right, you go around a corner and it'll go like that, get latched in there, and then when you go to straighten out, this chain just gets super tight, and yeah, that's happened a few times, and I don't have a solution for that yet, but I've seen guys have like caps with bolts that go, you know, something like that, but haven't done it yet. Good enough. All right, I'll get my light bar. We'll get out of here. this way. There's a turn lane. We'll stop and fix that chain, this dragon. Dragon, but it's probably that one. Just tighten it up a scooch. Yeah, because it's that. Okay, you stay there, I guess. Send it over here. Yeah. Yeah, I go right there. Okay, stay there. All right. Okay, let's continue on. So I thought he was kind of close to 19. We usually run 32. I know a lot of oversized guys run 25. I wonder how long this light's been green. I've just been sitting here. Look at that. He got it done. Never doubted him for a second. Thank you. this yard once before, and I don't altogether remember where it is. But I think it's just right over here. Road, but I'm gonna walk down there and look before I just go whipping on down there. Lock this up. I'm gonna walk down there and look at it all. Bring you guys with me next time. Down there, called the guy. I'm gonna put it out of the yard, and I think he's gonna move it in later. Make sure they can still get in this gate. I think we gotta scoot it forward a bit. Yeah. Okay, we'll scoot it up a bit. Make sure we're not blocking anything up there. Might be blocking this gate a little bit, but that doesn't really look like it's gonna be that much of an issue. Okay, let's go forward. Thank you. exactly the same place I was just in. This guy's got dump trucks and backhoes and stuff. He can move this thing. And I'll back up a couple more feet. Yeah, this guy's got all the stuff to move it. Didn't go that far, and that tire's hot. Okay, I do not want this on this meter, so if I back up another 2 feet like I want to, then that jack's gonna be right over the meter. Or right, you know, in line with it, and I don't want that. Maybe we leave it here, huh? You know what I mean? Did I not shut my door? I guess not. Yeah, maybe we just leave it here. Like I say, he can move it, so. We'll leave it here. Because I do not want to buy a water line. Baby wrench. Maybe a couple rocks on this side too. Leave the hitch on just in case I gotta move a trailer at the yard or whatever. Same reason it was on when I started this. So I gotta get in and I gotta take that outrigger out because it's leaking pretty bad. I did this one, I don't know, a year ago maybe. And you gotta take all the lines off and everything, drive it up on a land all, tilt the trailer back flat, back it up to the edge, drive this pin out, which has been in there for 32 years. You know, obviously on that side. And that gives it room to slide out, right? We took it to a, I ain't gonna say the name of them, but it's a tow truck manufacturer. And you know, they're in Arizona. They're the only Miller dealer in Phoenix. Anyway. So we needed the underlift rebuilt because it was leaking pretty bad. And, you know, it was a whole thing, but they didn't do the foot. They didn't do this right. I ended up fixing it when I got back because it was leaking worse when I picked it up than when I dropped it off. Took it back and yeah, it was a whole thing. So I won't do anything with them. Okay, we're done. This thing got a VIN number on it or anything? I don't remember seeing one. It's gotta have something though, right?
maybe not.
Okay. How does this one work? A bunch of cables and pulleys and... I wonder if this is one that, like, you hook, you set it down, you hook to a truck and pull it, and it picks it up like that. That's wild. I've never actually seen one of these. Like, closest to this I saw was, it came out and went up to a fifth wheel. But that was years ago. Cool. Call the office, see what they got for me. All right, we're getting out of here.
Truck, you know,
I try to use it in town as much as I can because it's a lot shorter than the white wrecker. Get in a lot better places, and like, it's got the back window, you know, I can see everything. So, and then I mean I did all the chrome in it, I put these lights in it, you know, my big CB, all that. It looks pretty good at night. It's got a bunch of lights down the side. And then I put the straights on it. It's loud. Because they used to, this thing was quiet. Come on, get out of my way. Thank you. Dashboard, the speedometer stopped working on me. I don't know if it's just unplugged. There's plugs back there, you know. I don't know if it's just unplugged or if some, I gotta spread some tabs open or something, you know. I don't know.